design of a low-power mixer for cell phones. This hands-on session presents a method for designing an active mixer based on a low-power transistor. The mixer that we propose to create is an upper sideband down converter. The RF signal is 900 MHz and the IF signal is 45 MHz. We first create a new workspace. And in the Design Kits panel, Manage Favorite Design Kits menu, we add S Parameter Vendor Kit and RF Transistors Vendor Kit to the workspace. Then we start to draw the circuit for checking the DC model of the transistor by creating a schematic. This analysis makes it possible to carry out a sweep of the voltage VCE and the base current IBB of the transistor. The objective of this study is to validate the DC performance of the model provided by ADS with the actual measurement results. Then we run the simulation, and in the open window, we plot the ICC current of the transistor. The measurement of the IV characteristics of this transistor is provided to us on Moodle. We copy measurement files to the data directory of our project. Then we run the simulation again, and in the plot, we add the measured IV characteristic to compare with the ADS results. We can see the perfect match between measured and simulated results. Bias circuit design. The next step is to determine the operating point of the transistor and calculate the values of the bias resistors. Collector voltage VCC and collector current ICC are specified in our objectives. It therefore remains to determine the base current IBB. To do this, we start to draw the circuit similar to the lab instructions. Then we run the simulation, and in the results window, we export the ICC, VBE, and IBB in a table. We need the ICC current of around 500 microampere. Then the value of VBE is around 707 millivolts, and IBB is 5 microampere. We now need to calculate the values of the bias resistors of our transistor. The obtained value for the base resistor is 8.4 kilo ohm, and for the collector resistor is 500 ohm. We test these values by drawing the bias circuit and checking the DC operating voltage and current. Verification of the RF model. We now verify that our RF model under a DS corresponds to the behavior of the transistor that is measured. To do this, we simulate the S parameters using the circuit shown in the lab instructions. We then run the simulation, and in the results window, we use the Smith chart to plot simulated S parameters. We also add measured S parameters to compare with simulations. We can see a perfect match between results. The next section of the lab is about the verification of the large signal model. We must then study the large signal behavior of our mixer in order to know its compression point at 1 decibel, which will allow us to operate our transistor in a nonlinear regime in order to create our mixer. To do this, we draw the circuit illustrated in the lab instructions. Then we run the simulation, and in the results window, we plot the simulated and measured output power. We can see a perfect match between results. The next section of the lab is about the design of the matching circuit. An important step in designing a mixer is to determine the impedances that are seen at each port for the RF input and for the IF output. At the input, we must have an adaptation circuit allowing a 50 ohm adaptation to the RF frequency, and a short circuit to the IF frequency to prevent the noise present at the input of the IF frequency from being amplified and interfering with the IF signal at the output. At the output, likewise, we must have a matching circuit allowing 50 ohm adaptation to the IF frequency and a short circuit to the RF frequency. Because of this, for each frequency, the impedances seen at the input and output are completely different. Therefore, for this part, we start drawing the circuit similar to the lab instruction. Then we add input and output matching networks. After we finish drawing the circuit, we run the simulation, and then we plot the S11 and S22 in the table and in the diagram. We can see without a matching network, the circuit is not following the desired return loss. Therefore, we calculate and insert input and output matching networks into the circuit and then check the S parameters again. After we finish drawing the circuit, we run the simulation, and then we plot the S11 and S22 in the table and in the diagram. We can see now with the designed matching networks, the circuit is following the desired return loss. Then we determine the new inductance value if we choose a capacitance of 33 picofarad, which allows us to obtain almost a short circuit at the RF frequency at the output. Then we run the simulation. And then we plot the S11 and S22 in the table and in the diagram. We can see with the newly designed matching networks, the circuit is again following the desired return loss. Study of the conversion gain as a function of the LO signal. In this part, we will focus on the effect of the power level of the LO signal on the conversion gain and the DC bias of the transistor. We will also look at the effect of the output resistor RL that we added. To do that, we start drawing the circuit according to the lab instructions. We run the simulation, and in the results window, we plot the output power as a function of the LO power in a diagram and in a table. Next, we can add a parameter sweep analysis to perform these simulations for different values of RL ranging from 1 kilo ohm to 10 kilo ohm. Study of the conversion gain as a function of the RF signal. We now analyze the IF output power as a function of the RF power. To do this, we draw the circuit as the lab instructions. Then we run the simulation and plot the PIF as a function of the power of the RF signal. We can also modify the value of the function by pressing F2 on the keyboard and writing the new expression as the lab instruction. In the next section to see IF, RF, and LO spectrums, we can disable the sweep in the harmonic balance analysis. We can add another schematic to the workspace and copy the previous circuit. The next section is about designing the layout for the circuit. For our application, we will use a low-cost substrate, FR4. This substrate is the most common in electronics. It is not optimal for RF applications with relatively high losses. However, the performances obtained for relatively low frequencies, less than 1 GHz, are acceptable. Therefore, first, we define this substrate in the ADS. For each component, we must associate an SMT pad footprint which will allow it to be placed in our layout. It is important to define them in the schematic window so that they appear in the layout. To allow for tolerance and component placement, we set an offset of 10 mm for each component. So in the next step, we define them in the ADS schematic. Finally, we start drawing the circuit according to the lab instructions. After we are done with the schematic and checked all components, values, and connections, we go to the layout panel, and from here, we choose Generate the Update Layout. Then we have the layout for our circuit. Final simulation from the layout. In this part, we will simulate our designed layout. To do this first, we create a symbol of our mixer. Then we copy it into a new schematic and start to draw the circuit according to the lab instructions. We can perform various analyses for this circuit by running different simulations.